We're a crippled nation. We're crippled because we have a bunch of nincompoops running everything. We've got the best Navy in the world that doesn't fire a shot. And then when they do, they hold the captain up for a court-martial because he may have killed a pirate. And I was reading a sailing magazine how the British originally treated Muslim pirates that they caught. See, way back in the early 1800s, it was the Muslim pirates from the area known as Somalia and also the west coast of Africa that were hijacking merchant ships, killing the crew and stealing the bounty. And I told you before that the U.S. government created the U.S. Navy warships, and the Leathernecks, the early Marines, wore leather around their necks because they jumped aboard the pirate ships and killed them with swords and guns, and the leather around their necks was to protect their necks from a saber blow by the vermin, the piratic gnomon, vermin. Okay, we all know that. We know basic history of the formation of the U.S. Navy. But when the British caught pirates, they would execute them on the spot, but they wouldn't throw them in the sea. They would take their filthy carcasses back to town, and they would put them in cages in the middle of town, and they would forbid the family from retrieving the carcasses of the pirates until they rotted on the bone. They made them sit there for sometimes years, rotting in public with flies on them. And you know it had a dampening effect on piracy? Would you believe? Would you believe that not bringing them to New York for trial or not giving them a $3 million a payout in the form of a whatever they give them doesn't work? Would you believe that? That worked better than giving them $3 million in ransom? How do you like that? That killing a pirate and putting his carcass in a cage in his hometown and making the cage sit there until the flesh rotted off the bone was actually a greater deterrent than putting them on CNN and asking them what their grievance was? Can you imagine how stupid the old British were and how smart they are today for catering to the Muslim pirates? But we're not far behind. We have a Navy with able-bodied seamen. We have very brilliant men running the ships. And we don't use them. Instead of blowing their dhows out of the water from 8 miles away, when you see them coming, you can see them coming. They can be picked up on a radar screen, God knows how many miles away. The touch of a button, and the pirate ship is gone, with the goats and their wives and their children if they take them along in order to cover themselves like they did for years. And it tends to reduce piracy when you kill a pirate. I don't know how that works. How does that work, that when you blow up pirates, there tends to be less piracy, but when you give them a reward in the form of a ransom, there tends to be more piracy? Does anyone know how that works? Can anyone explain that? Why would killing the pirates in a fairly high number tend to reduce piracy, while giving them the honey they're asking for, meaning ransom, tends to increase piracy? Can anyone figure it out? Because Obama can't.